So going on to make a little Chinese dress for baby Naya, and I don't really actually have her measurements now to hand, so I am going to take a guess on this, and generally my guess is just as good. So what I'm going to do is trim away the excess. I don't want to make hers too long. I think we have adequate fabric here to make baby Innaya a Chinese dress out of this. And so mark off a shoulder. So there may be little bits of things that you may find difficult to understand in the first tutorial on this, because I did hurry and I actually slightly hasted in doing that video. So what we're going to do is hopefully try and catch up with some of the parts that we missed. Now my suggestion would be to trial out the method and technique on something which is less expensive and easier to sew before you go on to attempt it on a brocade, Chinese type of brocade. There are problems, certain problems that you encounter with Chinese brocade that you may find easy to stitch on others, and that is that the brocade is slightly difficult to sew because of the fact that it frays a lot. You can do this design on cottons as well. It doesn't really have to be Chinese brocade to actually perfect the method and technique. And I would say that perfect the method and try it out before going on to do anything major. There is a slight variation that I'm going to do in baby Innaya's compared to the other one that I did, and that is that I want to actually close it, even though I want to sort of cut like a Chinese at the front. I want to actually leave it open, and I want to leave the galette open from the back. So the zip, I want to extend it all the way to the top of the back of the neckline. And again, we're going to mark it across on, obviously Innaya is smaller. We will mark this. So although we're doing this in the Chinese style, I'm going to close it off because it means a lot of messing around at the front of the dress. Now if you remember, I mentioned in the previous video that we're going to recut this on another piece of fabric. So any spare piece of fabric, and what we're going to do is try and align it so that it's the pattern actually comes in the same place. But we're going to make this a little bit larger. This time I'm actually going to make it quite a bit larger because I want to turn the same material, fold the same material up so that it makes my work a little bit less. Sometimes what happens is a lot of the methods and techniques, you can fine-tune these a lot better after experimenting with them. So when I'm going to attach piping on this and then really just reattach. So what we'll do is if we put these we want absolutely identical, because this is where the problem can arise with the two pieces if they are not absolutely identical. So some little cup sleeves to go with this dress. I think this would have been nicer if I had done this in another color, but because I've got this fabric left over, I'm just you know what, I hate wasting, and I think that's probably I could probably do with, you know, I've got so much to do, and sometimes I think I'm just glutton for punishment when I go and create work for myself. So, little cap sleeves to go on. A couple of other little bits and bats. One is the fabric for attaching to the zip, and then I also need something to neckline. Interfacing. Inaya's neckline is going to probably be about 10 inches. Fold the fabric in interfacing in half, and then measuring 2, 4, 5, I will do it 12 inches and then trim it down. That is the cut glutty for her neck. I have a feeling that's still going to be just a little bit wide. should be fine.